Welcome to the second episode of Learn with Turing. My name is Jose and I'm here to make the learning process simpler for you. In the first video, we took a brief look what React.js is, as well the career perspective of a React developer. If you haven't watched it yet, click on the link into the description section below and watch it. But for today, we are gonna use this to send a message to our Node.js application using this. And let me show you the system design for this application. In one hand, we have the Arduino that uses bidirectional communication using the serial port. In another hand, we have a React app using WebSockets. And in the middle, we have our custom event emitters that every time we receive a message through the serial port, we'll emit an event and broadcast the message to React.js. And every time we receive a message from the React.js application, we'll emit an event and send the message back through the serial port to the Arduino. The Arduino will ask for a message, will read the serial port, it will process the message, change the LED color, and then it will restart the program. The Node.js will connect to the device through the serial port, will subscribe to receive message, process the incoming message, and emit an event using our custom event emitters and broadcast the message to all WebSocket clients. This is our Node.js application, but before I go through this, let me show you what I usually do even before create the index. Create this folder called docs. Let me show you what our data structure look like. The data structure that we are going to use today will be type JSON, and it will have a type from 5 to 20 characters. We have a data from 0 to 200 characters. This is an example of message. So we have data string, type string, which is optional. Let me show you how to create communication using the serial port. So once we install and require the library, you will need the device path and the device baud rate. It means we are going to listen that specific port, okay? It will allow us to receive and send message through that particular port. And once you list it, you will see the list of the devices connected. And all we need to do is match the device path with our device path. Once it match, we can create a serial communication, okay, passing the device location and the baud rate. We are going to subscribe to the open event and also close event, and also subscribe to onDataReceive. And to write message through the serial port, we just need to call our object and call the method write. And the first argument is a string, and the second argument is a callback. And let me show you our custom event emitter. I create this file to make it easy to understand. So we will have a listeners, okay, which will be a map. And then we have two functions, one function to subscribe and one function to dispatch the event. When we are trying to subscribe, if the listener doesn't contain the type that we are trying to subscribe, we are going to add it. And on the dispatch, we are checking if it doesn't have the type, we are return. So if it does, we are going to dispatch the event passing whatever we come from the data. All right. And here is an example how to subscribe and how to dispatch an event. Let me execute this. Then you'll see what I'm talking about. Node examples event emitters. And what we should see, let me comment this first. And once we execute this, nothing happened because I'm not dispatching it. But once I dispatch, let's execute it again, we should see rendering and the data that I pass here. So once that's set, let me show you the device class that I created using this event emitter and the serial port communication. So it's right here. So as you can see, it's almost the same. I just comment every line. And here I have this on function to subscribe to an event. And then I have this emit event, which will write a message through the serial port. And then we have the dispatch event. I'm doing the same I'm doing there, but just more code here to check, to validate the message and throw errors and catch errors. Okay. And let's create our server. So I have the server right here. Let me show you. So the server will be pretty simple. We just need to import a device from our device, we need to create a new object, Arduino. Let's call it Arduino. And then we have a new device. All right. So passing the device name or the device location and also the baud rate. And then we have our object here and we are ready to subscribe to events. Let me show you how to do that. We can call our Arduino and then on to subscribe. And then I will subscribe to on connect. We're going to console log the Arduino was connected. Just this. And let's execute this code and see what happens. We need to call yarn and then parse the file and then execute this. Start server. Let's see what we get so far. So we are executing this. That is Arduino is connected. We are trying to match it. Let's see. All right, nothing happened. I just see a dot here. Let me stop it and let me check the events. Oops. So let's go to our device class and check if we are emitting this event. So once the connection is open, we are doing unconnected. So let me go back to the Arduino and say unconnected and let me start it again. So the Arduino was connected. So let me stop this. And then I have another event called on disconnected. Okay, let's do this. Arduino disconnected on data received and it will return a data. And how could we send a message to the Arduino? So first we will call our Arduino. And then we are going to emit. The emit has two arguments. The first one is the type, then the data. Both are strings. The data is a string or a number. So let's go back there and let's send the event change color. And the data will be 105th. So let's change the color to 105th. Okay. And let's see what happened. So we should receive a message saying Arduino, the Arduino was connected. And then we are writing message right, so it worked. So give me a thumbs up for this. What we could do to change the LED color dynamically. So let's create a new LED variable. Okay, with the scoped variable called LED color. And let's initialize it with zero. So once we receive a message, well, in the message is read mode, we are going to increase the LED color by 25 and then we need to check if the LED color is greater than 256, we need to reset it. LED color will receive zero. And then let's start our program again. So we should see the Arduino was connected and then we are going to send message increasing by 25 for the Arduino. We are going to change the color. This is it for today. I'll be back very soon with the next chapter. Till then, consider giving us the big fat thumbs up if you enjoyed this video and tell us in the comment section below what more would you like to learn. And don't forget to subscribe to Turing.com and keep your learning spirit alive.